our main policy priorities, we can summarize them in about three areas. First is to ensure that the policies, the regulation we have is an enabling regulation to ensure that we move and develop the ICTs, the IT sector. And the second bigger area is to ensure that we develop the infrastructure that we require that allows access and connectivity in an affordable manner. And then the third part, when we have done that, is to ensure that we use that infrastructure, those regulations and policies were put in place to attract partly the private sector, and where it's necessary, some public-private partnerships. At the moment, the ICT contribution to GDP is about 6.5%. Uganda is a population of about 34 million people, but already ICT is contributing over 1 million people in employment, directly and indirectly. Investors always go where there is demand. And given our level of development of ICTs, there is not only a demand, there is a need that we must roll out, penetrate the countryside, and ensure that infrastructure is complete, ensure that these services are available. We still have to roll out the infrastructure, especially on this broadband infrastructure. We still have to roll out or develop our e-government services. We still have to roll out IT services related areas. We need to invest in BPOs. We need to invest in innovation and technological parks. So there is a whole range of areas where we can invest. And fortunately, we have an enabling policy, whether it's an economic policy or regulatory policy, that attracts investors. Technology changes fast. As I talk now, we are trying to review our strategic plans and investment plans for the next 5 years, taking into account the new changes in technologies, take into account how we can also adjust our regulatory framework and even our legal framework to ensure that we move with the change. I think what is important in ICT is to see that you have the correct strategic plan for your model, because countries differ. You need your own model to suit your country. You use the same technologies, but you use them appropriately to suit your country. We have seven foundation sectors that are meant to be the transformation sectors, you know, energy, road transport, agriculture, and ICT is one of them. And basically, it is to develop that ICT so that Uganda in itself, we use ICT in all areas of our transformation, whether it's in government, whether it's preparing it for business, whether it's in even rural transformation itself. We want to take advantage of, for example, when we move from analog to digital, what do we do with digital dividend? Use it because it's a cheaper spectrum to roll out and penetrate our rural areas, because Uganda is basically rural and agriculture. See that we reach our people and we use it to transform Uganda into an information society that we want, which will tie in with our own vision 2040, where Uganda will hope to be a transformed modern society. Our experience so far in our time we have been with these policies and the attraction of the private sector, there are quite a number of areas where the private sector will not easily go. We did establish a universal access fund to support the areas where the private sector doesn't go. But Uganda being mainly rural, 80% of operation is still rural. That's a big challenge because it needs expensive infrastructure to get to the rural communities. That's one challenge. The other challenge is to develop the human resource.